All right, we're back.
We should be back up.
Let's just make
yeah,
sure.
Yeah, so for whatever reason, Twitch is being a little bit messy.
Yeah, it seems like it's Twitch then.
I don't know. All
right, so yeah, just making sure it is up.
Broadcasting. If someone could confirm that in the chat, that'd be awesome. It does pop up live again for me, so... Yeah, it does seem like it's a pretty normal one.
Yeah, Twitch must just be under a heavy load. Sorry about that, guys. Yeah, everything's fine. Alright, so, yeah, let's get back into this. The gateways are in production at the front of the wall. The natural just finished up, and Snute had a few things going on. He is getting his speed, still mining his gas. Oh, snap.
Well, we saw a little bit of a trickery earlier on, actually. It's mostly that that Snute managed to see that there was no second gas geyser down in the main base of Harstem. Yep. Harstem actually was delaying that second gas for the longest time, so Snute actually managed to see that, so he decided, okay, there's gateways down in the front. I don't actually know if it's going to be three or four gateways, so I might as well play it safe and just make a roach warrant for safety purposes. And he realizes right now, okay, it's not going to be any kind of aggression anymore, because then it would have already come. Because it hits right around the 6-minute mark, so he decides to go for the third instead.
Yeah, and we saw this against Night End, where he built the 5 defensive roaches. The Zealots are being whooped in right now. The Roach Warren finishes right now. 5 roaches immediately. 6, actually.
Game
PP.
Paused.
Okay, well, we'll just see what the players are up to. Apparently there's a light or something shining in his eyes. We aren't admin, sir. We aren't actually at the venue.
Yeah, and we don't have thin, so... Oh, God. That's a nightmare.
Yeah, that's pretty bad, actually.
MMA beat Flash. 2-0. And hey, Fairy Heart. I see you in the chat. And of course you still have mod. Of course, Fairy Heart, if anyone doesn't know, is, of course, Dignitas Blinn's mother. Who is fantastic as a mama mod, as we call her, because she always mods.
The mama mod?
Yeah, mama mod, because she always mods Blinn's channel, obviously, when he streams.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, mama mod. I don't forget that shit.
I should get my mom into StarCraft, man.
Yeah, man.
It'd be awesome.
Yeah, I'm guessing a lot of people in here didn't realize that was... she was a point pretty much the mother of Stefano as well for a few months when they were best friends. They were like inseparable.
Well, let's just wait for the players to just clean up this issue. Apparently, there's people walking around in a player area that are not supposed to be there, and they're walking into the players or bumping into them or something. You know,
I think they probably take
bad thing.
Photos as well, so they're pissing them off with flashlights.
Oh wow!
I'd imagine...
Really? Would people do that?
Yeah, people are idiots. People like. Would actually go up and touch players when they're playing. I've seen, I can't remember what one it was. I think it was I-47, which was in November. TLO came over. And TLO was obviously very manner. But someone went up to him and, put his hand on his shoulder while he was playing. And apparently he was like, "Get off me!" Which, people were like, "Oh my god, why would he react like that?" And then it's like, well, you fucking touched him when he's playing. What do you expect, you idiot? Don't distract players at all. Yeah, because it's such a solo game, and you have to have a solid mindset, and you don't want to be interrupted. You don't have to have that mindset changed, etc., etc.
Just really frustrating, I guess. It's really annoying, though. That's just something that the tournament organizer should definitely take care of. Honestly, that's just really annoying.
I like Kowak J Power.
Okay, so it does look like the players are moving, so it's cool.
And yeah, I should be allowed to ask for a mod on Grubby Stream. I know him. I want that mod. I like mod.
Gotta love how mannered the pro gamers are with each other most
of
the time.
Yeah, especially, obviously not all of them, but... Snute and Harstem, super mana.
Not just there to win, but also to be, sportsmanship. Pretty awesome. Okay,
Alright, so we jump back into it. Of course, we don't, we 100% do not want these players being distracted and that affecting their play. It's just, it's a big deal. It's a very big deal.
At all, yeah.
Alright, so we do have the four Zealots. The Forge has been added and the Robo's about to finish up, but it looks like Harstem wants to wait for an extra warp in. He did just build a sentry back at home, so we should have two more Zealots.
Yeah, he's gonna be warping in a little bit more. I'm not completely sure why. He might be just wanting to target fire down. Like, actually, this is a really uncommon position for a proxy final from Harstem.
Yeah. That's just our range.
That's
actually where I put my proxy pylon, because that is perfectly, as close as you can get to the natural on the third, without it being exposed and it doesn't get spotted by the tower. But this queen gets full on surrounded, so that is a nice little snipe, and that's all he's gonna go. He kind of taken that fight. There's not that many.
No, I don't think so, honestly. Like, it would have just taken too much damage. Probably, he just wants to play it safely. That might also indicate that he's planning to go for some sort of a two-base all-in, so he needs the units a little bit later, but obviously, we can't really tell that just yet.
Yeah.
And that might also be, like, a meta of the meta game, you know? He kind of wants Snute to think that it's gonna be a follow-up with an all-in. Hard to say at this point.
Alright, there is a probe head towards the third, and it looks like it will definitely go for that, but Snoot's gonna... Oh, he spots it just in the good time. Enough Zerglings are here that... they shouldn't have forced the cancel, but actually...
No, they will.
And oh, yes, they get nice. It, but that was... Ooh, that was a very close time in there. Harstem. That was like a little bit of a bluff for both players. It's like, you're not gonna stay there and try and get forced to cancel when I come.
Mm-hmm.
No, James Akins, you don't have mod here.
Oh, well. They gotta be making more and more of them drones, at least for Snute so far. Snute just going straight into the Hydralisk speed upgrade right there. This is something that he wasn't doing earlier. He was actually going straight into range.
Yeah.
So does decide to at least either try a little bit more aggressive play or just do a little bit differently. Now, once again, I like the way Harstem moves across the map. Like, first of all, with that proxy pylon he was going for. But now he's actually, like, if you take a look at the vision of Snute, Snute only just now sees it. When the units are already on this side of the map. Now, too bad for Harstem, there's not going to be any kind of proxy pylons, but he can just teleport at home whenever he wants to.
Yeah, if he forces a lot of extra units, a lot of drones aren't happening. And this is, once again, they're kind of bluffing. Snoot's like, you're not going to come attack me, you're making me force units.
Mm-hmm.
And then obviously, if you don't
big
force
units... Big supply block, actually.
Oh, that could be it then. And we do have 9 Hydras being produced. Nice force shields, locking a lot of them out. He's going to try and target it down.
Oh, he's going to just target fire it down, yeah.
Oh my god, he's going to force shields to deal enough damage to zone this all out, and... I would like to see him maybe get some kills before, because there's only one queen, so,
The big deal right here was just that Liquid Snoot made a mistake. He was just making 8 overlords because he was supply block when an army came in. And that once again comes down to, like, Harstem moving pretty much perfectly across the map and denying any sort of vision. And he couldn't see it until there was already units on his side of the map, and that's when the overlord started. So, it's, like, really solid play.
Yep, 71 workers, V59, the infestation pit being added on. Harstem's getting his blink plus 2 robo bay, so he's going for a different build altogether for the last game. Obviously, we know this already, but it's always interesting to see how the builds that they go for.
Mm-hmm.
And how
after doing so much damage, he's probably just gonna try and play super safe. Like, he doesn't really bother. Like, there's no need to really bother and do all-in as a follow-up. He's probably just gonna make Colossus and play it safe.
There is a war prison with 4 Zealots headed towards the third base once again of Snute, and there's nothing down here, but Zerglings... Oh no, those are Hydras. Hydra speed has finished up, and they're doing some... They're running very fast, and I don't think he's going to get this. Some Zerglings kills, and he's... Ooh, that was close.
That's risky.
He did not expect those Hydras.
That was really close.
Alright, but the supply is very even. 68 workers be 71. The army supply is only 12 difference, and... it's super, really super close. So, I don't know who's ahead just yet.
Harstem should not be losing this game anymore at this point. Like, if he plays it perfectly from here on out, he should be he denied so much income for the longest time, and he lost... Did he lose anything this game? Like, he lost maybe a few Zealots, but no gas at
Shift L? Shift L?
Yeah, that one isn't working for me.
It must be because it's game heart. What the hell? It says units lost, and he's like lost. Like, he hasn't lost the Colossus and these Immortals. Those are the units he has.
Mm-hmm.
That's weird. Well, I believe you have to use
big maybe, follow up though.
Yeah. And oh my god, this fourth base is actually gonna definitely get picked off. Yeah, there's no way to save this. The War Prism flying back in towards that third base, of course, doing a bit of two-pronged harassment. It's going to fly towards the natural, and does Snute spot it?
He might actually hit the timing right here. Like, Harstem is actually hitting straight before the Vipers will be out. Obviously, Vipers don't spawn with energy, so the Colossus will just be there and deal so much damage.
A lot of forces are getting dropped there, but he led a few units forward, so that was...
And there we go. He just goes back home. So all this time he's just making sure that Liquid Snute is on even economy with the Protoss player, and that's basically a situation that you cannot be in, Ezreal. If you're behind in economy or even in economy, you're just behind, like, even if you're even. So it is really important for Snute to either get a fourth base up or to make sure that this army doesn't max out, but I don't know if he will be able to do either.
Yeah, man. And also, like, Snute's not really getting his upgrades. He's getting plus two now, but Harstem's already getting his plus three, and it's one upgrade for both. So, you know, Harstem does have the little advantage there, thanks to the Chrono Boost. And of course, you know, you don't have to wait for your Hive or anything like that. As a Protoss, you just drop your Twilight and that's it. You can get your 3-3 pretty easily. But, ooh, Spire getting added into the mix. Ooh, Ventral Sacks. Ooh, Centrifugal Hooks, Numerized Carapace. We're gonna have some Bane Land drops. Bane Rain. I hope so, at least, anyway.
It might be.
It's obviously just to blow up all the sentries and maybe the High Templars, because Storm does not do a good job against these, but abductions.
Oh, that's hallucinations. Two hallucinations right there.
No, one was a real one, wasn't it?
One was a real one?
I'm not completely sure.
Because
there's still an hallucination left.
A lot of damage is
being dealt, and Snute is losing a lot of units. Harstem, as we can see, that is about to take his fourth base. Now, I think it's going to be Corruptus, but I can't really say. Plus three missile attack is in production as well, so the Hydro Roach doing very, very good. But it's got to be Bane Rain.
Like, Snute will have an incredibly hard time right now to clean up this army. Harstem had a lot of time to get more and more splash damage up. He actually has Colossus and High Templar right now, both obviously doing a lot of damage. As long as he controls this properly, there's almost no way that Snute can, like, win this fight, honestly. Obviously, if Harstem makes a mistake, it will still be, you know, there will still be a chance that Snute takes this, but...
We have a Greater Spire. I don't know what to make of this. The War Prism doing some harassment. I think it dropped some Zealots into the main, and now towards the fourth base. The fifth base is being taken, but Zealots are going to find that, and should be able to clean it up. And Snute, get into position. Storm is done. The High Templars, they're far forward. Oh, and he's going to eat the Storms. And the Storms, obviously, completely zone these out. These Zealots over here, definitely going to get that base, and they may... Zealous may get the one on the right-hand side. DT Shrine in production, double Robo in production right now as well. Taking him up to three Robo, but it's gonna... I think it's a Broodlord switch. I think he's trying to metagame him pretty hard.
Yeah, Broodlords are extremely underused right now. We actually saw them recently in a game that Solky played, and Solky is widely regarded as pretty much the best Zerg player right now, and he absolutely murdered with it. So it's still an incredibly strong switch. You don't usually see it after a Viper play, though. You usually see people attacking with, like, Roach Hydra... Roach Hydra Corruptor.
Oh my god, Harstem is a big counterattack. Yeah, this is a huge counterattack. All the units are running up here. Are these Banelands? No, they're Roaches. They're going to start dropping them on Colossus. That's
cool. Really smart, actually, because he basically just nullifies the entire force field.
Why the hell are there like 20 drones here? 16 drones? Interesting.
He's all in.
Yeah, he's all in.
He doesn't want to take this fight.
We need the force fields. And there's a storm.
Good High force was going out, actually picking up those units.
No! A drone just killed a High Templar! That is how often do you see that? And oh my god, these High Templars are going to get picked up. He's going to morph them into Archons after the storms, and...
Oh no! No!
He's dropping the roaches.
Oh, the Viper's getting picked up.
And GG gets called. And, you know, I'm not surprised that GG did...